In the previous lecture, we have seen the basic of mathematics, and now I am starting with the vectors. Actually, all the physical quantities are classified either with scalars or with vectors. These two are the terms which will distinguish the existence of physical quantity. What is a scalar quantity? The quantities which are represented with a number and having its unit is called scalar quantity. But in case of vector quantity, requires not only a number and units, but also a direction in space to represent this kind of quantity. This one is going to be very important for physics. Remember, for a scalar, we need number and units. For vector, along with number and units, we need a proper direction to represent the physical quantity. Scalar quantity follows arithmetic laws of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, like 2 plus 2, 4, 3 minus 2, 1, 2 into 2, 4. So all the scalar quantities will be treated arithmetically with normal mathematics. The operations will be similar with the algebraic calculation like addition, subtraction, whatever we do in our day-to-day life. But while operating with vectors, there will be a different kind of mathematics for vectors. The quantity which has its own direction will need a separate kind of mathematics called vector algebra to operate those quantities. For examples, if we see scalar quantity, any length, we say 1 meter length plus 2 meter length, we will directly answer 3 meter of length. Mass, time, there are more quantities like distance, speed, which are termed as scalar quantity. But in case of vector quantity, we have examples: velocity, acceleration, force. Velocity means what? The change in displacement per unit time. And the displacement is a vector quantity. We can also list here the displacement. It is also a vector quantity. So change in displacement per unit time, the velocity will also be a vector quantity. What is the key point which separate this quantity from the scalar quantity? It has its own direction. And the scalar quantity do not have any kind of direction. So displacement means what? Suppose I have to go somewhere in the like 15 meter from my home in the north direction, then I will reach a particular place. It means I have to mention the direction for reaching that particular place. But if I say that 15 meter from my home, it means what? In any direction, I go in any direction 15 meter from my home, in that case I will not be sure that I will reach to my desired destination. So wherever the direction will be introduced, the quantities will be termed as vector quantity. And we know from now a different kind of algebra is developed to deal with those quantity. We will be dealing with those algebras. representation of vector. The representation of vector will be complete if it gives the direction and magnitude. The symbolic form of representation of vector is like, suppose we are representing the velocity, then I will write the variable and an arrow overhead. Next, if we have acceleration, then I will write the variable and an arrow overhead. If we are representing the force, I will write a variable capital F and an arrow overhead. So a variable or an alphabet having arrow on its head will be used to represent the vector quantity. In some of the books you may find a bold variable, simply a bold variable written like this is also representing the vector quantity. And in other form of representation, suppose a graphical form, we have next representation is graphical form of representation of vector. In this case, a vector is represented by a directed straight line. Directed means what? An arrow at its head. This end is called head and this end is called tail. So it is represented by a directed straight line having the magnitude. A vector has its magnitude and direction along with units. Magnitude means what? The magnitude will be represented in graphical form in this way, that the length of this arrow will be equal to the magnitude of that particular vector quantity. In the direction, this direction of arrow will represent the direction of that particular physical quantity. Suppose I say I am applying a force of 5 Newton on a block in north direction. Then how will I represent this 5 Newton force in north direction? See, for such representation, we need to know the directions first. What are the standard directions which we should consider? Like in case of science, we consider this upward direction as north. This one is south direction. This is the east direction. This is the west direction. This standard is considered as the geographical north, geographical south, geographical east and geographical west direction for our consideration. Now suppose I have to show the 5 Newton of force in north direction. What will I do? I will take the magnitude or the length which will represent this magnitude. Suppose this length of the arrow is representing the 5 Newton in magnitude and in north direction they have asked to represent. So I will simply put an arrow in the direction of north. Now suppose if we have to represent a 10 Newton of force in north east direction. What is the north east means? North east means what? Exactly in the middle of north and east. Again, we will take the magnitude, such as the magnitude will be representing the, this length will be representing the magnitude of the force, that is 10 newton. Suppose this length is equivalent to the 10 newton of force, and the direction north east, exactly in between the north and east. This is the angle 45 degree. This one will also be the angle 45 degree. Now we can write this representation 10 newton of force in north east. You can also write the 10 newton force north of east. Means what we have written? A 10 newton of force which is north of east. Or we can also write the 10 newton of force east of north. We may have other values to represent. Suppose I have something like 15 newton, I want to represent 30 degree west of south. How will I represent this vector? I will take the length of a vector which will represent the 15 newton of force. Now 30 degree west of south means from south we will move 30 degree towards west, and the magnitude will be, the length of this arrow will be taken such that this will be representing the 15 newton of force. We may have other values. This 15 newton 30 degree west of south, it can also be read as what? It is equivalent to what? 15 newton, this is 60 degree south of west, we can also say that. Now suppose we have to write a 20 newton of force which is west of, I'm taking something 40 degree west of north. Means what? West of north, somewhere 40 degree from north in the direction of west. So I'm taking 40 degree west from the north, and the length of the vector is taken such that this length will be representing the 20 newton of magnitude. So these are the representation of few vectors using the graph. This angle is actually 40 degree. Now we can read this one also. You see, from west the vector is at what? 50 degree angle. So I can also write the 20 newton of force 50 degree north of west. So these are few graphical representation of vectors. We will need these concepts very importantly. Let's see one question on the direction of vectors. The question is, a man starts walking and walks 15 meter and 37 degree north of east. Then he walks 10 meter 53 degree east of north, then 15 meter towards west, then 10 meter 45 degree south of west. Now draw the path of the man. So I have taken first thing, he started from origin. This is the direction north, this one is south, then east and west. Now first, when he starts walking, he goes for 15 meter, and that is 37 degree north of east. Means from east towards north at angle 37 degree. Then he walks. From this position, the north will be upward, south will be downward, east will be rightward, west will be in this direction. So from this point, he walks for 10 meter, 53 degree east of north, means from north to east. It means what? From north to east, it means he carries his path, because this angle is 53 degree. Here also, if this is 37, this one will be 53 degree for 10 meter. Now, then 15 meter west. Now he walked for 15 meter west. Now suppose this is the direction west. So for 15 meter in the leftward direction. Then 10 meter 45 degree south of west. So this is south, this is west. South of west will be exactly at 45 degree at the mid of these two directions. So 10 meter 45 degree south of west. So this can be the way to represent the direction using the vector, and vector we know is used to represent the particle, the parameter which are having directions as well as magnitude and unit. You see, everywhere I have shown the direction accordingly they have instructed in the question. So this is the way to write any vector in its diagrammatic form. Now see few basic definitions like equality of vectors. Simple definition of this vector: the two vectors are equal if they represent same physical quantity and they are having same magnitude along with same directions. So this is the definition of equality of vectors. Next, we may need the angle between the vectors. Suppose one vector, vector A, other vector, vector B is given to us. Now we have to find the angle between these two vectors. Then I will manually do what? I will simply put vector A, and on the head of vector A, I will put the tail of vector B, and I will extend it in this direction, and we can see the or measure the angle between vector A and vector B. There can be the other way also, like calculating the angle between B and A. So you can put vector B first, then vector A next. So the angle between the vectors can be calculated, again can be measured. So next we will see, as I have defined that the vectors do not follow the simple mathematical algebra for the calculation of addition and subtraction, it has different mathematics called vector algebra. So I will start with addition of vectors. So first, there are few laws for addition of vectors. Initially I would like to define the triangular law of vector addition. In this law, using this law, the drawback of this law is that we can add only two different vectors. Suppose we have a vector, vector A, another vector we have vector B, we need to add these two. We can do either we place A first, and at the head of A we will place the tail of B. So what is the resultant? The resultant will be a vector starting from the tail of first vector to the head of second vector. This one will be the graphical resultant of vector A and vector B being added. Or you can also do one thing, the vector B should be placed first, then vector A, then you connect the tail of first vector to the head of second vector, you will again get the resultant vector A plus vector B. Here what is happening actually, vector A plus vector B, doesn't matter whether we are adding it as A plus B or as B plus A. We can write this addition also as vector A plus B. It means what? Placing first the vector A, or vector B plus vector A, placing first the vector B. This is called what? The commutative law. It means addition of vectors possesses what? The commutative law of vector addition. Next, there will be one more rule called law for adding the vectors, polygon law. Polygon law of vector addition. In this law, the drawback of triangular law of vector addition can be overcome by adding more than two vectors. Suppose we have vectors like vector A, then we have vector B, then we have vector C, and we have to add all these three. What we need to do? We will simply place any of the vector as first vector, then at the head of first vector I will place the second vector, then at the head of second vector I will place the third vector. So graphically, when we connect the tail of first vector to the head of final vector, then this one will be representing the resultant. So the resultant of addition can be written as vector R equals to vector A plus vector B plus vector C. You can see this is called the polygon law of vector addition. There can be many more vectors in this way. Simple law. Using this law, actually we will be writing the vector addition, and we can see the resultant in which direction it is actually pointing. Now next law which we will see, third law and most important law, called parallelogram law of vector addition. This is a very important law used broadly while solving the problems, not only in vectors, but actually this law will be used throughout the physics whenever we will be defining the vectors or quantity which are vector quantity. So what next? Suppose we have two vectors, vector A and vector B, okay, and it is given that the angle between the vectors is theta. So in parallelogram law, there will be the addition of two vectors and the angle between the vectors will be given. So what we need to do, suppose the angle between vector A and vector B is given as theta. So how to add using the parallelogram law? Actually this law states that if two vectors represents the two sides of a parallelogram, if two vectors represents the two sides of a parallelogram like this, you see, then the diagonal will be representing the resultant of these two vectors. This is the law. If two vectors, vector A and vector B, representing the two sides of a parallelogram, then the principal diagonal starting from same point will represent the resultant of these two vectors. Actually, this is vector B. It doesn't matter whether this vector is existing on this board. We can take it anywhere. But if we do not change the length of this vector and the direction of the vector, then this vector can be shifted from one position to the many positions. Suppose I have the vector B here. I can make it here also. I can shift this vector to this position also. But make sure we should not change the length of this vector as well as the direction of this vector. So what I have done? for the calculation of resultant, the magnitude of resultant. It is given already the angle between vector and vector B is theta. So this vector B is actually taken at this position because these two vectors are representing the two sides of a parallelogram. And we have seen the magnitude of this vector, vector A, magnitude is written with mod. The magnitude of vector A is actually representing what? The length of vector A. Similarly, the magnitude of vector B will be representing the magnitude of vector B or the length of vector B. So what I am going to do, I will simply make a right angle combination. I will take this one. If this angle is theta, this is also theta, because theta is the angle between vector A and vector B. So what is the length of this section? From the trigonometry, you can write this is the length of mod of B cos theta, and this length can be written as mod of B sine theta, and this length we have already modulus of A. So you can see we are making a triangle whose length is modulus of A plus modulus of B cos theta and modulus of B sin theta. So we have made a right angle triangle whose sides are known to us, and this angle we do not know. I will consider it as alpha. Now what is actually we are concerned of? We are concerned of calculating the resultant. Resultant is a vector quantity. Whenever we will be adding two vectors, it will, the resultant will also be a vector only. So the resultant of vector A and vector B, vector A and vector B will also be a vector quantity. So we know very well, for a vector quantity, to define a vector quantity, we need to express its magnitude as well as its direction. So for direction, we have to take some reference. I will make the reference vector A, then it is, the resultant is at angle alpha from A. So what I will do, suppose this is the triangle OA, I will take OPQ. In triangle OPQ, if you see, it is making a right angle triangle. So the length of resultant, means magnitude of resultant, can be written as base square plus perpendicular square. From simple triangular concept, mod A plus mod B cos theta square plus mod B sin theta square. Now I need to calculate this value. I will again draw the diagram. So I need some space. So the resultant can be written as modulus of A plus modulus of B cos theta square plus modulus of B sin theta square. So I will just open this bracket and will write modulus of A square plus modulus of B square cos square theta plus 2 mod A mod B cos theta. This three quantity is actually coming from expanding this one. Now plus mod of B square sin square theta. You can take the mod of B square common from these two quantities. So what it will become? It will become modulus of A square plus modulus of B square sin square theta plus cos square theta plus twice of modulus of A modulus of B cos theta. Now you see, this quantity sin square theta plus cos square theta results as 1. So the resultant vector has its magnitude equivalent to under root mod A square plus mod B square plus twice of mod A mod B cos theta. This thing we need to remember. If you see, this is mod A plus mod B cos theta, we have seen in the diagram, and the height is mod B sin theta, and we have now the magnitude of resultant. The resultant should also be a vector quantity, so we have calculated the magnitude of this resultant. Now we need to calculate the angle in which it is pointing actually. So what I will do, I will simply take tan alpha equals to perpendicular upon base. So what is perpendicular? Mod b sin theta upon mod a plus mod b cos theta c. So we can answer here that the resultant has its magnitude mod of r at angle alpha. You see from what? This is the basic direction of vector A. At angle alpha from vector A. You need to remember these two things which we have derived. The resultant, magnitude of resultant, and the angle made by the resultant from its reference. Now suppose in this formula you want to make the reference as vector B. What you will do? You will simply change the AB from here. It means in that case this is vector A sin theta mod B plus mod A cos theta. Means whatever is the reference you want to make, I have made vector A. That thing should be here without any trigonometric function. This is the way to remember this formula. Actually you will have to remember. You will have to memorize. And the number of questions as you will be performing, the formula will be getting more stronger in your mind. Now we will see few examples. Suppose we have two vectors, two forces, one having magnitude 10 newton, other having magnitude 5 newton at 60 degree. We know very well force is a vector quantity, and these two vectors are at 60 degree. This is 10 newton, this one is 5 newton. We want to calculate the resultant force applied on any object. So this angle they have given 60 degree. So the resultant force can be written as A square. Suppose this one is A, 100 plus B square, 25 plus 2AB, 2 into 10 into 5 into cos 60 degree. Cos 60 degree and 2 will be cancelled, 125 and 50. So the answer is 175. You can write what is this value? 25 into 7. So 5 root 7 meter can be the answer. Again, one more question can be there. Two forces are there acting on a body, both having magnitude equal as 5 meter and angle between them as 120 degree. What will be the resultant force acting on the body? I will calculate 5 square plus 5 square plus 2 into 5 into 5 into cos 120 degree. Again use the basic trigonometric concept. Cos 120 degree will be minus 1 by 2. This 2 cancel. So the answer will be 25 plus 25 minus 25. We can write the 5 unit answer. So there can be many more problems. If you want to see some of the cases, like some important cases, suppose the vector A and vector B has angle in the same resultant